You were right. This is the perfect venue for the wedding.
This necklace will make it even more perfect.
I'm so glad you're here. My fiancé Daniel invited me to dinner with his mom tonight, so you're gonna be my plus one, okay? Come on, you owe me one. I can't help it. I'm just so nervous. Daniel hasn't told me anything about his mom. Do I look okay? I hope she likes me.
Welcome.
Daniel, what are you doing out here? Do you want to get sick again?
Mom, Ellie's here to have dinner with us.
And I told you no. Come in, Galaxia!
I've got to talk to my mom. She's just protecting me. She'll listen to me.
Neptune's beard. Never thought I'd live to see a sight like that. And from sweet Miss Abigail, no less. Well, you can't cross now. The only boat here is high and dry. Belongs to a landlubber named Chris. He tends a bar yonder, but I doubt he could get it in ship shape. Well, that's enough yapping out of old Charles. Time to fix up that bridge. Here, this shovel will serve you well this time of year.
Hey there. Cold out there, isn't it? How about a drink to warm you up? My boat? Did old man Chuck send you? He's always nagging me about that rust bucket. Look, if anyone could repair it, it's Daniel. He lives up the road. Before you go, that's my friend Cody over there. He's real nice, but a little superstitious. Said he's waiting for a stranger from a dream. Maybe it's you. Here, the coffee should perk him up.
It's you! Oh, sorry. I must have dozed off. I'm Cody. My uncle is our tribal shaman, and he dreamt that you would come here to stop Abigail. Yes, my uncle is a powerful shaman. He works at the clinic for alternate medicine. He can help you defeat Abigail. My uncle says Abigail unearthed forbidden magic that disrupted the natural balance, but he believes you will be the one to restore it. He said I should give you this amulet. It harnesses the power stored in animal totems. Chris keeps his mouse totem under the bar. Use the amulet on it. You'll see.
Thanks. Look, I'm sorry about all of this. You have to trust me. My mom is a good person. This is all my fault. I never should have surprised her with this. I just thought if she could meet Ellie face to face, she'd like her. What? Oh yeah, Chris's boat is a wreck. But I can fix it. Can you help me gather some spare parts for it? You can have this, too. I'm going to try to call my mom. Don't worry, this is just a big misunderstanding. She'd never hurt anyone.
will blow me down. It's fit as a fiddle. Come on, anchors away.
Hello there. This weather is just dreadful, isn't it? I came to see Mr. Inupik about my back. He's the shaman of the local tribe, and he runs this clinic. We're all very proud of him. He does a lot of good for our little community. I just finished seeing him and was about to drive home when I noticed my tire was flat. I don't have a phone with me, so I'm not sure how I'll get home.
Greetings. I am Inupik, head shaman and director of this clinic. My nephew Cody called and said you were on your way. I'm sure you have questions. I met Abigail when she brought her son Daniel here. He had a terminal illness and was in great pain. I soothed his pain, but the illness I could not cure. When I could not perform the miracle she desired, Abigail became very angry. Of course, but I'm not sure where I put them. Can you give me a hand? Take it. Even a simple photograph can hold much power.
Goodness, I don't even know what to say. You're so kind. Here, take this. I've got to hurry home now. Goodbye.
Stay away from my son.
Daniel wasn't getting any better, so Abigail asked me to turn to dark magic. I refused. The ritual was far too dangerous. But she wouldn't listen. She stole some of my artifacts to use on her own. The artifacts hold the power of cold and hypnosis. That's how she can turn people to ice. She's found a source of evil magic up in the mountains. We have to stop her before she goes too far.
You're the one whose sister was kidnapped, aren't you? I'm afraid it isn't the first time that's happened around here. A girl named Claire went missing recently. Her body was found in the mountains. Daniel was inconsolable. Yes, she worked right here at the museum. She just went missing. A few days later, her body was found. Her disappearance was very odd, though. Even the police can't explain what happened. Daniel, Abigail's son. He was dating Claire at the time. They were very happy, but her death changed everything. Daniel couldn't come to terms with his grief. Oh, I've lost my glasses again. I can't see a thing without them. They're somewhere here in the museum, I think. I'm afraid I can't remember the code to the museum door, though. Here, this piece of paper will help you get in. Ah, I can see again. Thank you. I truly hope you find your sister soon. Be careful. The mountains are a very dangerous place.
this. Why do you have Claire's phone? Oh, it's you. Where are you now? I couldn't get through to my mom on the phone. You're in the ghost town? Okay, I'm close.
There you are. I just don't understand what's going on here. Why is my mom acting like this? I found this key in her diary. This hut was also marked on the map. Maybe we'll find some answers there.
Thank you.
Oh no! We have to save Ellie before it's too late! I guess we need to head down into the mines, but we'll need two pairs of skis.
I always dreamed of being famous. So I went to the shaman for help. I wasn't famous for long, and the shaman got my soul after I died.
Follow me!
bought a lot of land to mine for gold, but I didn't find much. I heard stories of a shaman who could grant people things in return for their youth. I didn't even hesitate. I get rich all right, but I couldn't enjoy it. My life passed faster than I could even sell my first gold nugget.
Thank you. When my twin brother and I were born to our tribe, the shaman predicted a great future for us, full of noble deeds. My brother was always good at things, and he became apprentice to the oldest shaman in our tribe. But I was arrogant. The elders couldn't see my true potential. I became a recluse in the mountains. There I learned the ways of darkness, and it soon overtook me. I've been powerful ever since. The evil in the mountain flows up into my hands and allows me to help people just like my brother. Though the price is higher.
Stop!
No, Daniel, your life is too important to me.
It's over now. You're safe.